What's up, my friends? Welcome back to another ElectroNews video. I know that you are wondering why I haven't posted each week, and that's because I realized that I was repeating the videos, because you see, there's not much happening in just from one week to the other. So I thought it should be nice to make this news about ElectroNews each month. So this is another video. So today we'll talk about the projects that I've been going on this month and the projects that I'm working on right now for this week. As for example, this here, as you can see, my workshop is a mess. So in this video, I'll tell you about a future project related to thermocouples and Peltier modules, about some 3D printers, because this month I made three videos about printers for DLP printers and FDM, and also about the project that I'm working on right now, which is this huge tank that will be 3D printed and will have a lot of cool stuff. So guys, let's play the intro and let's get started. So guys, here we are with another weekly update for ElectroNews, and remember that from now on, this weekly update won't be weekly, will be monthly, because as you realized, I was repeating myself in each video. The projects that I was working on 1 week wasn't finished till the other week, so I would have to talk about the same project two times. So anyway, I think this will be better, and in this way you'll have an update about my channel, about me, each month. So remember that in this video we'll talk about this huge 3D printed tank, which is the project that I'm working on right now for this week. We'll talk about Peltier modules and thermocouples, and also about some 3D printers, which are DLP printers with resin and an FDM printer that I'm using right now, and is probably one of my favorite for this year. So let's get started first with this project. By the way guys, as you can see right now, I'm wearing glasses and I had no idea that I'm more blind than a bat, but I went to the doctor and made the test, and right now I'm wearing a glasses with 1.25 astigmatism. I'm not sure how this is called, but anyway, I have to wear glasses when I'm working or reading something. When I'm going outside, I don't need this, but right now I do. So yes, now I have glasses and that's it. And I also have something new in the workshop. So guys, that new thing is this. This is a MacBook. Actually, this is new for me, but it's not that new. I think it's from 2015, I'm not sure. And this was, my brother gave me this because he right now has a new one, because from his new job, they gave him a new one. So he gave me this old one. So as you remember, I was using an HP laptop with Microsoft, and right now I also have Microsoft installed here. Even this is a MacBook, but it will work a lot faster because it has a lot more RAM. The graphics are a lot better, and it's 4K. So 4K or 2K, I think it's 2K. Anyway, with this I can work a lot faster. So this is right now what I'm using for my scripts, for my website, and for working here with the Arduino in my workshop. So I'm pretty glad to have this because with this I can work a lot better. Okay guys, so let's take a look at the workshop. As you can see, it's a mess. I have everything here because right now I'm recording a video. And as I told you in the previous videos, when I record something, my workshop is a mess because I don't have enough space. So all the tools, I will leave those laying around. And it's a mess. So let me show you the tank and explain you a little bit what I have in mind, because this won't be finished for this week because there are still a lot of 3D printed parts to design and also to print. So let's see the tank. Okay, so let me show you how it's what I've been doing till now. This here is not glued in place. And below this, I will use, for the top part of the tank, I will use wood, because imagine printing this in PLA. That will take me a lot of time, and also I have to divide it in six because the printer that I'm using is a maximum 300 by 300. So for this part, I will use wood, but the rest of the tank is all 3D printed. So this is what I have right now. Remember, this is the same tank as this one. This is version 1, this is version 2. As you can see, this is double the scale and it's huge. I haven't measured it yet, but in a moment I will do that and tell you the size, the final size and the scale related to the real tank. So for now I have the main bottom case. This is all 3D printed, and as you can see I have 6 parts for everything, because otherwise it won't fit on the bed of the 3D printer. So I have these 6 here, all screwed in place, and then I have this frame and the skirt. This skirt is also screwed in place with some screws and also with a little bit of glue to make sure that nothing will move. So let me tell you the differences between this first one and this second one, and not only about the size, there are a lot more differences. One of the main differences is this part here. As you can see, this will move and it will have a spring here connected, so like that this will be connected to the wheel on the outside. So with this system, I will be able to make a suspension for the tank, something that this tank doesn't have. As you can see, there is a straight rod from one side to the other, and the wheel can move. So with this bigger one, I'll have suspension for all the wheels. As you can see, I have this strange looking hole, so the wheel can move up and down. Right now this part is not good because it's not thick enough, so I'll design a thicker one, so we'll be able to use two bearings, one on each side. And with that I will have a better suspension. Another thing that's different, as you can see, this old version has DC motors with the gearbox, one for each side, but in this case I will want to use some brushless motors, so I will have this smooth rod here connected to the gear for the wheels, and then we'll have another gear inside connected to the motor. And I will use these rails here to pull the motor behind and tension the belt. And like that I will be able to use brushless motors, which are a lot better to control with an electronic speed controller. So this is also a difference between this one and the new version. Oh, and by the way, since this is a lot bigger, I will have a lot more space to put more stuff in it, such as bigger speakers. I want to place a smoke machine, so when I will start the engine, I will have a little bit of smoke coming out from the pipes. And also maybe in the turret I will be able to fix this in place. This is an automatic BB gun, so I'll be able to shoot BBs. And also maybe this module here, this is a high voltage module that will create a huge spark. And of course some speakers and the DF module, so I'll have some engine sounds, some cannon sounds, and so on. So there will be plenty of space for the battery, the motors and everything, because this, as you can see, is huge. Okay, so what more do we have here? These are the wheels that I will be using. I have three types: the thick one, then I have this one which is medium width, and then I have this one which is a little bit more plain. So I will use those with these tracks here. And as you can see, these are all 3D printed, and I have like 200 of these. And this will be a lot of work to merge this together. And to merge the tracks together, I'll use the same filament that I've been using to print this. As you can see here, I'm not sure if you can see. Let me just make a zoom. Okay, so as you can see, this is the same plastic filament. So all I've done was to melt the tip of the filament and like that, keep in place the track. I'll try to put on the view on the screen some videos with that, and I will use that for all the tracks. And then when I will have around 2 meters, I'll place that with the wheels. So this will be the tracks. They are not very light, but I hope the entire tank won't weigh too much. So as you can see, I have hundreds of these, and this took me like 3 days to print using 2 printers, because I was printing 30 or 40 at the same time. So yeah, I have 2 boxes, and maybe I'll have to print even more because I'm not sure how many tracks I will need. But once I know that, in the final tutorials, of course, I will leave you the part list and the links and everything you need to make this. As always, I will share this for free on my website, ElectroNews.com. Hey guys, here we are another day, and I have the 2 printers. These are resin printers. So let me show you a little bit about this. For the AnyCubic, I already posted the review. But the printer is not ready yet on the market, because AnyCubic told me that they will have it on the market in 2 or 3 weeks. But anyway, you can see the video, I'll leave a link below. And for the Photon, which is from Iligu, I haven't posted a review yet because it's not finished, I'm still editing it. So I'll post it maybe this weekend. So let's see the printers. So here we have the printers. This is the AnyCubic Photon Mono SE. And this is not yet on the market, but it will be soon. And this is the Iligu Mars version Pro. As you can see, it has the P here. I haven't used the normal version, but anyway, we have to compare these 2 printers that I have right now. First of all, the specs are pretty much the same. I think the screen for this one is a little bit bigger, and this is a little bit smaller. As you can see, the printing plate is a bit smaller. But anyway, the printing quality is the same. I mean, I know this is a bigger print, but in any case, the print quality, the layers is kind of the same. I can't see any difference. But I do like here that you have this door, so you can open it and you don't have to take out the entire case. But at the same time, I do like that when you take out the entire case, you have more access, because you can access from all the sides. But here you have this door, so you can only access from the front. You can access the print from the sides or record it with the camera. So that's what I like about this one, and also about this one. The touchscreen is the same. This has Wi-Fi control, and this doesn't. This is advertised to have a active carbon filter here to get rid of the smell of the resin. And then the specs are pretty much the same. This is using 2 rails for the Z-axis made out of metal. This is just one, but I haven't had problems with that. They both use USB memory stick for printing the parts. And that's pretty much it. So let me just show you a closer look at the quality of these prints. Here we have a few of the prints. This is the one that I like most. And if I turn it, you can see that we even have some small details here on the back of the helmet. I'm not sure if I can focus that. As you can see, we have some very, very small details. And just have in mind that this is just the size of a 50 cent coin. These are not that big. But as you can see, we have some very, very great details. Look at the Eiffel Tower. Actually, guys, I did mix up the prints because the Eiffel Tower was printed by the Anycubic. And these were all printed with the Elegoo. So have in mind that this cool print was also printed with the Anycubic. I can't say which one is better because the print is the same, but all I can say the difference is in the design. As you can see, the design is quite different. This is made all of metal and this has the top side of the printer made out of plastic. So here we have the prints made with the Anycubic. This is the Baby Yoda file. We have the Einstein file and the Eiffel Tower. Here we have the prints from the Elegoo. This is a very small print that I've made for testing the printer. As you can see, we have some very, very small details. The tip of these pillars is just 1 pixel. We can also have some hanging structure up to 75 degrees, as you can see here. We have some small text. What is this? Anyway, we have some very small text there, but the engraved text inside of the plastic is not that good. As you can see, it should say here ElectroNews, but you can't see it that good. And I've tested the size of this circle. It should be 5 millimeter, and yes, it's exactly 5 millimeter. So the print quality is quite good. We have very good results. So these were the two DLP printers that I've reviewed this month, but I also made a review with the Artillery X1, the Sidewinder X1, which is an FDM printer, and it uses those silent step drivers and makes the printer very, very silent. And it has a very cool design. All the cables are made with some strips, and with that we have a very clean look because you don't have loose wires, and in overall the print quality is great. So that is maybe my favorite printer for this year till now, because it's silent, it's not that expensive, it has a very clean look, the heated bed is with AC power, so it will heat up very fast, and it has all the specs for dual linear rails, it has some nice magnetic end switches for the Z-axis, and well, it's a cool printer. I'll try to put some videos on the screen. So guys, this were the reviews for the printers for this month. So I guess that this is the update that I have for this month, because otherwise the video will be very long. We have seen the tank, we have seen the printers, and also a new tool that I have in my workshop, which is that laptop here, the MacBook, and it's a new tool that I'm using now every day for my scripts, for Arduino, for the codes that I use here in my workshop, and it will make my work a lot faster. So guys, till the next month, keep up and see you later, guys.